ships from far away. We're already here on the earth today. Just so small that you wouldn't believe. Travel at speeds that we couldn't conceive. That means one could slip right by, undetected to the human eye. Try to catch one, you wouldn't stand a chance, because they're just so small yet so advanced. Those tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we'd never notice. So while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could slip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we'd never notice. So while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship could slip right by. What if tiny spaceships the size of gnats end up getting eaten by hungry bats, or snatched up by a frog's long tongue? The tiny spaceman would be long gone. Lost on a mission is one of the few to study the giants of planet blue. That's me and you. You wanna know why? 'Cause we are the aliens in their eyes. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never notice. Then while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship can slip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never notice. Then while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship can slip right by. What if they're from a planet that's cold and gray, in a universe light years away? And even though it sounds like it's very far, what if it's the universe next to ours that makes us neighbors with a space-time fence? If the universe begins right where ours ends, a trillion galaxies and trillions of stars, and somehow they found their way to ours. In tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed. And while we're looking up at the sky, a tiny spaceship can slip right by. Tiny spaceships under our noses, just so small we never noticed.